So pattern number 13, and this one is simple one. So there are two combinations, SSION and TION. Both are pronounced as, I'm going to write in Devanagari first, just so that some people have clarity. Sion. Sion.
A bit, yeah.
Yeah, Sion. Or will this be also similar in English? Sion?
In a word, yeah. Phonetics.
Phonetics, yeah. I mean, if you can learn that, then we can write it precisely. I think Soha can do it right now. Unfortunately, I'm teaching. So, your bad luck. Sion, it's very, very simple sound actually. So, you're going to be very happy about this one. How about this one?
Education.
Education, oui. That means?
Education.
Right. No marks for guessing here. How about this one, Akshata?
L'information.
L'information. That is correct. Which means? Yeah. Okay, so people who are wondering why are we saying information, we're going to study this pattern next, this thing. So stay tuned. Right now, let's focus on Sion. L'information. Okay. How about this one? Babu.
La condition.
Co. Now here again, this is the English influence. We say condition in English, right? But this is not English. So we have studied this pattern, this thing. So can you now try again?
La condition. Co.
Yeah, co, fantastic.
Condition.
Yeah. Ha. Yes, yes, got it. Condition.
La pression.
Yes. What does it mean?
Pressure.
Yes, you are right. How about this one? Very, very tough one. And that goes to Nusrat.
L'admission.
L'admission, which means?
Admission.
Fantastic. Okay. Are you happy that you took admission to program A?
Oui.
There's only one answer to that. Yeah, you know that. Okay. How about this?
La progression.
La progression. Progression. Which means? Progression. So this is simple, right? Both TION and SSION is Sion. Education, information, condition, pression, admission, progression. Cool?
Yeah.
Cool.
Good news about this, we are going to learn the genders in French, but almost all, and again, once I say all, I want to say all, but because it's a language, I'm going to say almost all of the words which are ending with Sion like this are feminine in French. Okay. So that's something that you should remember. Feminine. So that's why you see la, la, la. And where there is no la, because it starts with a vowel. So we are putting L apostrophe. Even then, these words are feminine. Okay.
So for both TION, double SION, it will be feminine.
Correct. Correct. This is something that you need to be a little, you have to practice a lot over this one. So I'm going to write down combinations which are going to make, or we're going to pronounce them in a similar fashion. So quite a few of them actually. These are pronounced as nasal ah. Okay. For example, if I have to write it in English, nasal ah. We know ah, right? The alphabet, this alphabet in French is ah. Correct? Just make it nasal. Ah. Okay? So that is this sound. If you need help, we have a legendary singer, musician, songwriter, actor, director, producer, and model. Himesh Bhai Resmiya, the legendary artist from India. He is master of this sound. One of his favorite songs is Jalakadik La Ja. Jalakadik La Ja. You remember this song?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you are a Himesh fan, you're gonna master this song.
Is
so
it your favorite? Is it your favorite song?
If you want to insult me, Akshata, then I would say rather curse me, rather say some really bad words about me. To me.
I think it's your favorite song for teaching.
Yeah, you can say
trust
that.
Me, Atif, it is his favorite song for teaching. He uses it everywhere.
I believe you.
I think we're just putting up with it. That's why.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
We get,
Atif,
we get.
Atif, you just lost 2 free sessions 6 months down the line.
But we get it.
Okay. Okay. Let's move on. guys, we are getting late. Okay. So let's take some examples. Soha, can you pronounce this?
Le pain.
Which means?
Bread.
Yeah. This is going to be tricky. Samir, because it's tricky, it's you.
Okay. Le train.
You're making a little bit on. It's un. Je la kadeke la ja.
Le train. Train.
The second one was good. So guys, the more mistake you make in this, the more times I'm going to sing that. So, you know, your destiny is in your own control.
So guys, please control. I guess no one likes Simesh here.
Okay. Kiran, your turn.
Thank you.
No, you have to say that.
La Fon.
It's La.
La, La Fon.
La Fon, which is end. But this is not the end of our session, of course. How about this one? We studied this earlier. Akshata, you remember?
Yeah. It's France.
Pans, yeah. Chloe, could you pronounce this for us, please?
Le prince.
Yeah, which means prince in like in English. Now, we studied this today, PR. We also studied IN, which is A, like a nasal A. How about this one, Pramitha? The something, your favorite.
Wine.
Le vin. You use this, right, for cooking?
Yes.
Yeah. How about this one, le copain, which means?
Girlfriend, boyfriend, something.
Not girlfriend, boyfriend. How can it be girlfriend, boyfriend, both?
Okay, boyfriend, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
La raison.
You're still saying son. Raison.
La raison.
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 Grape. It means grape. Like a raisin in English, right? Raison. So this is all like nasal ah. So let's take more examples. I'm sure you might have heard of this word. Akshata. How would you pronounce this?
Andhya.
Andhya, which means Indian, but this is a Indian. Masculine one. For you, yeah.
Andhyan.
Andhyan.
Andhyan. N.
N. Andhyan. Okay.
Okay.
How about this one? I'm going to take this one. Samir.
Important.
Important. We studied AN today, right?
Yes, ta.
Can you try one more time?
Important.
No, this is nasal A. This is on. Important.
Important.
Fantastic. Important. Which means important. It's an adjective actually, and it has feminine version also, which is, but we're not going to say that right now. How about this one? Kiran.
Yeah.
Can you please pronounce that?
Le tombre.
Tambre. This is nasal A. Chalaka dekhe la ja. Le tambre. I think he's still enjoying my singing. He's lost in my voice. Okay. Le tambre, yeah. Which is stamp. How about this one? This is one example of the... Aishwarya, could you pronounce this?
Faim.
Which means?
Hungry.
Hunger, actually. Correct. Je faim is I'm hungry, but this is hunger. Faim. Well, is this noun, but is this masculine, Chloe? La faim or la faim?
It's feminine. La faim.
La faim. Okay. Which means the hunger. Okay. It's a noun. How about this one? We are going to that territory now. Akshata, one more time.
Plan.
Which means, do you have any
plenty
idea?
Plenty.
Yes, yes, correct. It means plenty, or it also means full. Another meaning is full. Okay, how about this one? It's a little tough one, but I'm going to put somebody in spot, and that will be Mahina. Entendre. Ton, it's a étendre.
Étendre.
Yeah, en is this one. A N. You know, you remember this? We studied this. Yeah, where is that? Here. This. These four are en. Okay. So you guys need to differentiate between this and this. So can you try one more time, Mahina?
Étendre.
Yeah, correct. This means to switch off. It's a verb. Okay, like switching off the fan or lights. Okay, like ventilator. Étendre. Okay. Oh boy, so many of them. So we have covered examples of this, 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 this. These two are still remaining. Let's get rid of that. How about how about this one? Okay, Samir, one more time. Your name calling is there. Hmm.
Olympic.
Ah, nasal ah. Jalak dikla ja. So again, can you try one more time?
Olympic. Olympic.
Correct. Olympic, which means it means what it. What do you think it means? That means Olympics. The same. Yes. How about this one? Pramitha. How about this one? What's the meaning? Or first pronunciation?
La.
Remember that YM and YN are pronounced as a, nasal a. Hmm.
La son, la, sam, samphone.
Symphony, oh,
la, la symphony,
which means symphony.
Symphony,
yeah, correct. Is this the correct spelling of symphony, Soha, or we do also we have N I E in English?
No, no, we have Y.
Okay, yeah, I'm not that bad, am I? Okay, she would not even answer that. Very good. How about this one? How about this one? Who wants to take a stab at this?
Synthetic.
Song kyun bol rahe ho bhai? Kitna matlab main, what do I do now? Main 50 baar gaunga. I will sing that song 50 times.
Synthetic.
Synthetic. And by the way, we studied today that TH, we don't have to say H. Synthetic.
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 Thoda nasalness kam hai. Himesh ka tumko sunna padega. You need to listen to Himesh few times. Okay. Which means synthetic. I mean, it means what you think it means. What's the spelling? Oh boy. I'm going for C. Yeah. Okay. That was my thought. Soha, is this correct?
Yeah, I'm watching you. Yeah, it's
correct. Okay. Okay. Synthetic. Cool. So guys, I know this is a tricky one. It's not, this is probably the one which gets the, it's like it takes the longest time to master because we are just not used to saying these things. I mean, as soon as we see this, our mind tells us important, or you know, so you would say important or something. I mean, you might get this pattern right, but you'd still say important. So practice. One thing which is going to help, I think, in first thing is to, you have to memorize, in the sense that you must know that this combinations means something. So you must know that first, and then you should practice the sound. So there are two aspects to it. So what we're going to do, we're going to give you assignments after this session where you have to write this down, this kind of combinations. So the more number of times you write them down, you will retain them. Are you getting my point? So first you need to retain that information, that these kind of combinations and patterns exist, and after that you have to master the sound as it is. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Let's move on to the last one. How much time we have? We are almost 5 minutes or 6 minutes over, but let's get this over with. What was that? How many patterns did we study? I lost count now. Pattern 14.
15th.
This last one felt like 7 patterns in one. Okay, so this is 15th, Akshita?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So this one is, I'm going to let Chloe teach this one because I'm just going to suck at this very badly. Okay, these three combinations. Okay, I'm going to write in, I don't know what I'm going to do with this. I mean, even if I write this one, I'm not sure if anybody can read what I'm writing. So I'm going to still try to write. Can any one person in this class can read this thing? These three things, what I've written?
See, so.
Oh, nice. Who was this?
Kiran.
Oh, wow. So, Devanagari script has its takers. So we succeeded. Okay, cool. Okay, so let's write some examples. I'm just going to write three examples because we are running out of time. So one each, and then I'm gonna take help from Chloe to see if, and then I'm also going to try my luck at it. But yeah, and for this, I'm going to write. Okay. So examples are there. Now let me, how about Chloe? Could you give us a start? Can you pronounce, please?
La psychologie, le psoriasis, le pseudonyme.
Right. So there's that. I'm going to try now. Okay. And nobody's allowed to laugh. Okay. Deep breath. La psychologie. Le psoriasis, le pseudonyme. I messed up, didn't I?
Non, c'est bien.
Okay, le pseudonyme. It's so, right? It's not su. It's like the English we have su, pseudonym. But it's here so, not su. Okay, le pseudonyme. Cool?
So can guys, you repeat this a second one? Le pso.
You want me to do myself that torture again, or you want Chloe?
Yeah,
to
the second one I'm not getting.
Chloe.
Le psoriasis.
Le psoriasis.
So Ria. We have this. I had this girlfriend. Ria. Okay. I just made that up. Did you pay attention to what I just said?
What?
That.
Okay. So, le psoriasis. Okay. Now again, S is between two vowels. So unfortunately, that also is coming into picture a little bit. But the thing to focus here is this thing. So we have to say a little bit of like psychology, psoriasis. Pseudonym. Are you hearing that small p in the beginning?
Yeah.
So that is there. In English, we just silent, right? We say psychology and psoriasis and pseudonym. We don't even make attempt to even slightly pronounce the p. But that's not the case in French. We have to pronounce it a little bit. Correct?
Yeah.
I know this is not the easiest one. So, I mean, see, French, this is probably one of the toughest things about French, the pronunciations, especially for, you know, like foreigners, like us, people like us, this is not our, you know, like mother tongue. So it's going to take some time. Okay. We have studied this in the beginning so that with practice, with the amount of time we spend in studying, you know, we master it with time. So we have to study this at the beginning so that you know all this theory, you know all these sounds, and then, you know, with time, you improve their sound, improve your sounds, improve your pronunciations. Only thing I'm going to ask you guys for is be adamant that you will make the best possible attempt at these sounds. I mean, don't take the shortcut of, you know, using your Indian accent or Bangladeshi accent or, you know, any other accent. Don't take that shortcut. Try. It's not going to be like, we're not going to speak like Chloe. we will not be able to. That's not going to happen, not at least in that limited amount of time that we have. But we must make our best attempt. It's an attitude. It's an attitude thing. Okay.
We.
Yeah.
Awesome.